SimplySimpleStamping.com. I'm so glad you could join me for today's Make It in Minutes flashcard. Guys, this card was so incredibly fast. And this card in particular, it's all about the layout. The stamp set you use, the background you use, you know, that's entirely up to you. It's about this layout and how quick and easy it is to create this card. So let's get started with a Make It in Minutes flashcard. Let's go over the cardstock you need for today's flashcard. I am going to be using Crumb Cake as my card base. I have that cut at 8.5 by 5.5, scored at 4.25. So it's going to fit into a medium sized envelope. My flashcard pieces today are in Blushing Bride and Very Vanilla. My Blushing Bride piece is cut 2.75 by 4.25. My Very Vanilla piece is cut 2.5 inches by 4 inches. I'll be using 2 stamp sets today. My background is going to be done with the hardwood background stamp, and then my focal images will be with the brand new Love What You Do stamp set. Let's go ahead and work with the hardwood background. So I've got a Crumb Cake ink pad. I'm going to ink up my stamp, but I don't want it to be quite so bold. So I'm going to bring in some scratch paper, and I'm going to just stamp off a couple times. Now let me bring in my card base, and I can just lay my card directly on there. I'm going to go ahead and just take this paper. We're going to give it a nice back rub. And you can see that gives a really nice soft look. And that's what I was going for. Let me set this aside so that we can work with our Very Vanilla. I'm going to bring in a Blushing Bride ink pad. And we're going to use that really great watercolor wash that comes in the Love What You Do stamp set. So I'm going to ink that up. And I'm actually going to stamp it off twice because I want a really nice soft background here. And I'm going to stamp that at the top of my Very Vanilla cardstock. Give that a nice press. See, I got that nice soft look. That's what I'm going for. I can now come in with the Crumb Cake and the flowers. We'll stamp those right in the center. And this stamp has 2 different kind of inside flowers. So let me come in back in with my lovely little scratch paper here. And let's stamp off once. And I'm going to stamp, stamp off, stamp, because I don't want this to be too dark. Now I can come in with this center, this smaller one, and we're not going to stamp off, and we'll go 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. It just kind of gives it some nice shading. Now my stamped piece of cardstock, I do want to cut it a little bit shorter. So I'm going to cut, I think I'm going to cut about 1/2 inch off. And then my flashcard piece here, I'm just going to tear just a little bit off of the bottom of that, because now that's going to layer and it's going to give me just that nice kind of more detailed edge. I really like that. Now, before I adhere this down, I'm going to take my linen thread and I'm going to wrap it around a couple times. I'm going to tie it in a bow here on the side. All right, I've got that done, and I actually have some Stampin' Dimensionals on the back. And so that is kind of, you can see I'm kind of using that to hold down the linen thread. That's going to keep that ribbon from sliding around. But let's go ahead and work on our sentiment. So I have the stamp. I'm lucky to have a friend like you. And we are going to do this in Crumb Cake, and we're going to stamp that right there on our Blushing Bride. I'm going to come in with a 2-inch circle punch, give that a punch. I've put some snail adhesive on the back of that. We're going to put this kind of up here in the upper left-hand corner. Now I can take my Stampin' Dimensional backings off, and this is going to be ready to go right on top. So we're going to be able to hide that circle. Let's add this right here. Perfect. Now we are going to want to add some dimensionals to our sentiment, and you can see we really just kind of need the dimensionals around this side. So let me go ahead and take these backings off, and we can adhere our sentiment down right off the side. Way cute. Now we're going to add a little shine to this. Here we go. I'm going to come in with the Wink of Stella brush. And guys, what I want to do is I'm going to very gently, I'm going to go over the word friend, and I'm going to give it a little shimmer. It's actually quite relaxing to do this. And I found I just kind of filled in some little spots. Really nice to give that the shine. So let me do this. Perfect. Now let's come in and we're going to add that Wink of Stella to our flowers. And I'm just doing the inside So I'm not going to where we stamped with the blushing bride. I'm sticking to just inside the crumb cake. Pearls are always a nice touch, right? So we can just add 5 of these and our last one. And guys, there we go. That card goes together so fast, but talk about a beautiful card. I'm telling you, it really is that fast to make. Now remember, the background can be anything you want. You might even want to just choose an embossing folder. Whatever image you put here, let it be anything you want. I know you've got a ton of stamps. Time to get those out and get some ink on them. And this layout, it's fabulous. It's simple and it's quick. And sometimes that's exactly what we need, right? Well, listen, if you want to see more information on my card today, head over to simplysimplestamping.com. Look for the May 23rd, 2018 blog post. I'll have all the information there. I'll have the measurements for you, the colors, all of the supplies that I use. So if there's anything that you would like to add to your next order, you can just click a pic and we'll have it shipped right out to you. So be sure to check it out. Now, if you also like the idea of flashcards, but you don't like to do a lot of cutting, be sure to head over to simplysimplestamping.com as well. Look in the upper menu bar for flashcards to go. This is where I'll have everything cut and scored for you. You're going to have everything you need to make 40 cards, and that's going to include the envelopes as well. So it's really a great way to get started with flashcards without having to do all the work, right? You just get to do the fun part, the stamping part, the creative part. So be sure to check it out at simplysimplestamping.com. And guys, thanks so much for being a part of today's video. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.